All right, well, a Sydney man has taken up a peculiar hobby. He's restoring a retired supersonic combat aircraft, and he's doing all the work in his suburban front yard. Harley Jones has spent the last 15 years collecting parts of the F-111 Aardvark. The warplane was once used by the US and Australian Air Forces during the Vietnam War. And we have the builder himself. Harley Jones is with us now. Harley, why?
Why not? I think it's a bit of a combination of a few different things. I've always had a passion for the F-111. Like many people in Australia have, it's a really important aircraft to our, you know, to our defence history. And I guess to, in general, aviation, a lot of the things that contributed to the next generation of aircraft from the technology that it brought forward.
Harley, neighbours sometimes have strong opinions about things going on in other people's homes, particularly their front yards, particularly when it's a little unusual. What do your neighbours think about this?
My neighbours are pretty tolerant, actually pretty tolerant, understating it. They're very tolerant. We've got a really good neighbourhood. Everyone looks out for each other around here. It's actually, I used to rent around the corner and I love the neighbourhood so much that I ended up buying here. So, yeah, it's a really good place to live and the neighbours are great.
Now, Harley, how did you learn how to do this? I don't imagine there's, like, an online course. Like, how did you get the skills to do this?
12 months ago, I couldn't put flat pack IKEA furniture together. I would have called Airtasker. I'm just not that kind of person. I just never had technical skills at the hands. But I just got sick of watching other people do, you know, fabrication and welding and all that sort of thing, and thought, you know, that'd be really amazing to be able to do, and I'll give it a crack.
Some parts required you to get an international traffic in arms permit. Why is that?
The F-111 has a lot of parts that are in common with the F-14 Tomcat. So the F-14 Tomcat was the Top Gun aircraft, the very first Top Gun movie. And the export customer for that was Iran. Now, the Americans don't want the Iranians getting hold of any F-14 parts. So given the F-111 has these parts in common, they're very, very touchy about it.
Most of us remember the F-111 for buzzing the straight at Bathurst in big events like that. So you get this thing finished. I mean, are you actually going to fly it? What are you going to do with it?
And I wouldn't fly anything that I've built, put it that way. No, look, it's definitely not going to fly. It's for static display only. I'll have it all power up. Everything, the whole cockpit will power up, all the instruments will power up, all the screens will have displays behind them. So it will look like an operational aircraft as far as when you're sitting in it goes. But as far as flying goes, it'll have about the glide slope of a Bessemer block brick.
Well, the plot thickens with you, Harley, as well, because apparently you're a snake catcher by day as well. Yeah, there's a lot going on here. So is it fair to say your favourite movie is Snakes on a Plane?
I've never actually watched it. I think I'd cringe. I have a hard time watching snake catcher shows. A lot of the things we see in the media these days is just daily life for us. It really is. It might seem crazy on TV, but it's honestly, it's daily life for a snake catcher.
Hey, Harley, incredible job you've done there. Thanks so much for your time.
No problem at all. Thank you very much.